In this illustration, we'll study about uniform circular motion and uniform electric field. Here we are given with a situation in which a simple pendulum of bob mass m and charge q is suspended in a uniform horizontal electric field E as shown in figure. And here it is saying the bob is held in position A. And from this point, it is projected horizontally with a speed such that it continue moving in uniform circular motion. And we are required to find the projection speed of this bob. So, in this situation, we know well that if we throw it horizontally in the vertical plane, it will move in a vertical circular motion, which can never be a uniform circular motion. So, in case of a pendulum, there is one uniform circular motion possible, that is when it performs circular motion in form of a conical pendulum. Here we can analyze the similar case, like the bob is experiencing gravity mg in downward direction. It will be experiencing a force qe due to the electric field. So due to this, the resulting equilibrium position of the bob would be somewhere along this line, which is along the line of the resultant of these two forces acting on it. If this angle is theta, this can also be written as theta. And we can write the equilibrium position of bob is given as, here we can write, the value of theta is the direction of resultant force acting on this bob, which is the resultant of electrical force and the gravity force. So here it can be written as tan theta is equals to QE by MG. So this is the value of angle along which the bob will be in equilibrium. If it is released, it will come to equilibrium position over here. And the resulting force acting on it can be written as MG effective, where G effective is the effective gravity acting on it or the resulting force acting on it, which is the resultant of these two perpendicular forces acting on it. So we can also write the effective acceleration acting on bob, which is due to both gravity and electric force, can be written as G effective is equals to root of this g square plus qe by m whole square, as in downward direction acceleration acting on it is g and in horizontal direction it is qe by m. And in this situation, if this is the equilibrium position and from the initial position the bob is thrown horizontally in a normal direction, say if we throw it with the speed u, which is in the direction normal to the plane of this paper, then it will have a tendency to revolve in form of a conical pendulum like this, as this is the line along which the net force is acting on it. So the ball will continue in a conical pendulum in this fashion which I have drawn here. And in a conical pendulum, the speed of circular motion of a particle of a bob remains same. So here we can write for uniform circular motion in a conical pendulum, the speed of circular motion is given as, this we already studied in concept videos, you can have a review of that, where we have studied that the speed is given as root of rg tan theta. So here it will be r. Instead of g, we take as g effective multiplied by tan theta, where r is the radius of the circular motion, which can be given here as l sine theta. So if we substitute the values, this u will be root of the value of r, we can write as l sine theta, and the value of sine theta from this triangle or from this triangle we can directly write as sine theta is equals to qe divided by qe square plus mg square root multiplied by g effective, we can write as root of this mg square plus qe square divided by m multiplied by 10 theta. 10 theta we already calculated as QE over MG. So in this situation, this gets cancelled out. The final result we are getting is here QE square can be taken out of the sine of root. And M can also be taken out multiplied by root of L by G. That will be the final result to this situation.